सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन अगेन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग. मिराल आर यू देयर?
यस यस.
सी मिराल, द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द थियोरेटिकल प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट द पॉइंटर विल लैंड इन सेक्शन लेबल विद लेटर ए. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दाना जीशान एवरीवन लिसन टू मी केयरफुली. Whatever the question asked, they asked me letter A in how many times? I saw A, there are two times in this spinner. I wrote two here, and then in the denominator, I wrote 10. Why did I write 10? Because you will see the total sections. Total sections. How many total sections are there? 10. That's why it will be 2 over 10. And the answer is 1 over 5. Now better I frame my own question and ask you, because you all will never tell me that you don't get it. Come on, Dana. If I ask you about the letter U, what is the answer? Letter U, Dana. Letter U. What is the theoretical probability that the pointer will land in a section labeled with letter U? First thing, check how many U are there in the spinner. Girls, Dana, Zeeshan, why am I leaving the whole lesson? I'm not going further just because to make you all perfect in this. And when I'm calling out your names, you're not replying me. Dana and Zeeshan.
Yes, miss.
Who's this, Zeeshan?
Yes.
Where were you, Zeeshan?
I was in the bathroom.
Okay, Gia. Listen to me. How many letter U you see here in the spinner? Letter U?
One.
One. And total how many are there?
Ten.
Ten. So what is your answer? If I ask you theoretical probability. The
one over 10?
Excellent.
10.
This is called theoretical probability. I'm so sorry, Zeeshan. Sometimes I'm calling out and I'm saying, because I'm worried. This lesson is there for the quarter test. I don't know how will you all do it. Okay? Dana, are you there? Miral, tell me about letter J. What is the answer? Letter J. Miral?
Yes.
Letter J, theoretical probability. What is the theoretical probability of letter J? How many times you see J in the spinner?
2 times.
2 times, right? In the denominator, so this will be in the numerator. What will be there in the denominator, Miral? In the numerator, whatever they have asked you, like if they ask you A, 2 times. If they ask you S, 1 time. That you will write in the numerator. In the denominator, you write a total. How many total sections are there in the spinner? How?
10.
10. So 2 over 10, that is 1 over 5 is your answer. Did you get it?
Yes.
Okay. So after 300 spins, the spinner should land on the letter A approximately how many times? So you have to see, one time out of 5. So I'm so sorry. My WordPad, the pad which I write with, it's not working. 1 out of 5. So what is when it is 300 spins? See, girls. One spin type a whole number. I think it will be 300 times, because 300, let me type here one more. It will be 300 times, because one spin, A probability is 1 time, 1 over 10. So 300 over 10 is 30 times. just a second, let me just write and then explain you. 30 times. Incorrect. Okay, question help. Let us check the question help. After 300 spins, okay, the pointer lacks such a letter A on a given as a fraction. Predict how many times the pointer will land in section A with the letter A after 300 spins. So two spins at each. So 600, let us write 606. 600 times. Let me check the answer. Again, it's not correct. Use proportional reasoning to the total number of times that spinner will land on section A. Proportional reasoning, okay. One spin is 1/5. 300/5. Just 560 times. Let us see here. Okay, guys. Now, one time, how much was it, girls? One time, with one time when you spin, it was 1/5, right? You got it before. What is the theoretical probability? With one time, you got it as 1/5. With 300 times, how much will you get it? How much will you get it? So of course, this is division. You know very well, what did I teach you? This is division and this is multiplication. Simple, 1 divided by anything is the same number. So I have 1/5 times 300. I have 1/5 times 300. 300 divided by 5, the answer is 60. And this is what you got here. Judy, everyone, did you get this or no? The B1?
Yes.
For 1, you have 1/5. For 300, you have how much? This is how you do it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, next question. Noor, are you there? Did you come back?
Yes.
Please read this.
The spinner is divided into 8 equal parts. Find the theoretical probability of landing on the given sections of the spinner. Use pencil and paper. Are you able to use the probability to predict future events?
Explain. 3 greater than 2. P greater than 2. Girls, how many numbers are there greater? Not girls, only Noor will answer. Noor, how many numbers are there greater than 2 here? 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. There are 6 numbers out of 8. So if I write 6/8, simplify. Simplify 6/8. 6/8. Of course, you will simplify by dividing with 2. 2 times 3. And 2 times 4. Am I correct? Divide by 2.
Yes.
So what do I get? 3/4. Let us
4.
Write. Let us write here as a fraction, 3/4. Did you understand this? Again.
Yes.
Everyone, it's your chance. Let me do this question with you. Judy, if I ask you, less than P less than 4, what is the answer? Find the theoretical probability of P less than 4. How many numbers less than 4?
3
numbers. 1, 2, 3. Very good.
3.
What's your answer? Is your answer 3?
3/4.
3/4?
4.
No. 3/ the total. How many sections are there?
3.
Yeah, Judy. 3 sections are less than 4. But how 4. Many sections are there? In the denominator, you will always write the total. Probability means thing which is asked in the numerator but total in the denominator. So you told me 3, that is correct. 3 over what? How many sections are here?
8.
Huh, very good. 3 over 8 is your answer. Zeeshan.
Yes, miss.
What is the theoretical probability of getting more than 6? A number getting more than 6. How many numbers can you see here more than 6? It will be asked like this. P more than 6. Probability. Like this. P more than 6. What is your answer?
Less.
What?
Less.
How many numbers are there more than 6? In the spinner?
2.
2. So your numerator is 2. And then total how many are there? Total how many are there?
9.
Count again.
8.
Very good. So 2 over 8, they come in the same table. I need to divide by 2. I get 1 over 4. Did you understand this? Anything what you don't understand, Zeeshan, here?
No.
Meral. P. Meral. P less than 5. Tell me the answer, Meral. P less than 5. Hello, Miral?
Yes, yes, sorry, miss.
It's okay, tell me. Less than 5, how many numbers you see and how many total? You know now how to do this. Probability, theoretical probability less than 5.
Miss, the number is 5?
I told you, probability less than 5. How many numbers you see? Less than 5. Less than 5 in the spinner. How many numbers you see less than 5 in the spinner? Miral, did you understand my question? This way I'm gonna be late. Please, Miral. Noor.
Yes.
How many numbers do you see less than 5?
4.
So what is your answer?
It's
4 in the numerator and what is in the denominator? 4 over
8.
Excellent. So that is nothing but 1 over 2, right? After simplifying, yes. It's 1 over 2. Any questions you have?
No.
More than this, I don't know how should I make you all perfect. Each and every girl I'm trying to make you understand these questions, girls. Even like when I was young, I used to feel probability is a tough lesson. Okay, Zeeshan, read this question out. At school, there are the same number of?
At school, there are the same number of boys and girls. A student is chosen at random to raise the flag. How many times is it expected that a boy will raise the flag over 30 days of school?
Okay, how many times is it expected that? Give me a moment. Okay, guys. At school, there are the same number of boys and girls, okay? A student is chosen at random. They choose at random, a girl or a boy. Either it could be girl or boy. So how many times is it expected that the boy will raise the flag over 30 days of school? Girls, when I say boy and girl, they're equal. That means they have equal one in one. They have one in one chance. Like if the girl has one, the boy also have one chance. So can I write 1/30? Can I write 1/30? Because equal chance.
Yes.
Let us see. 1/30. Correct. To find the expected number of days, multiply the total amount of days by the probability of boy being chosen. That means, okay, boy can be chosen by either, see, there are two people, either a girl or a boy.
Boy.
A girl or a boy, okay? So, see. The probability of choosing a boy or a girl is half. And if I say this is for one day, this is for one day. For 30 days, it is 30 times 30. So if I do 30/2, what is the answer? If I do 30/2, what is the answer? If I say 30/2, the answer is 15.
Yes.
Did you understand? Did you see the mistake? I directly wrote 1/30, but no, because the chance of choosing a girl and a boy, there are only two people, and chance is 1/2. So for one day, it is 1/2. For one day, it's 1/2. So for 30 days, how many? Like that. For one day, it's 1/2. So for, this is one day. One day, 1/2. So for 30 days,
we multiply it.
How many?
15.
Now, girls, will you all be doing the additional practice by your own? You have additional?
Yes.
Richard, Lenny, Hannah, and Raquel together buy one season ticket. First of all, tell me how many people are there?
Four.
Okay, so it means it is one of four. If one boy is playing, it's like one out of four, right? One out of four. If I say about Raquel, so he has 1/4 chance. If there are 68 games, so that means I will multiply 68. Divide 68/4 and tell me what's the answer. It is 17, I guess.
17.
Let us see. Did you understand this?
Yes.
Till now, you're just knowing how to do this 1/4. Now you know that when they ask you that if there are so many games, not in one game, if there are so many games, you multiply with those many games. No, is clear?
Yes.
Sure. Because this is lesson two. Lesson one, I finish on. Like tomorrow, I'm going to do lesson three like this.
Okay.
We'll go to additional practice. Come on, girls. Please solve, check your answers. Solve, check your answers. And if you don't get correct answers, tell me, teacher, how did we get this? See, almost like same names and same thing we have solved in our class today. Remember?
Okay.
Do you see that? Spinners and A, almost like same thing. I'm sending you in the group. Please, girls. Solve them and let me know if you don't get it.
Okay.
You know your quarter test is in week 10?
Yes, next week.
Next week, yes. You know that or no?
Yes, I know that.
Better, I will send you the portion also, just a second. Miss Vela will be sending you. Just wait for her. But this is the one I have sent already to her. You have your, what you call as math and science, both written in this so that you can start preparing for it. Anything else? Okay.
No.
Girls, I'm really worried. What are you going to do for this? So better, inshallah, once I will also post some of the homeworks so that you get a, you know, get an idea how from additional practice, girls, from additional practice, more than enough if you practice these. See,
greater than two,
how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6/8, same questions are there, what we are doing in the, okay?
Okay.
Okay, girls, have a nice day. Any other things what you would like to know?
No.
Quiet, today grade 7 is too quiet. What happened? Dana, why were you not with me? Okay, anyways, bye-bye, dear. Have a nice day.